In keeping with the theme of drums, since we just released our brand new pack, Cobalt Drums, check it out, link in the description, I put together 7 of my top tips on drum processing, creation, and more inside Ableton, so let's check it out. LFO/delay trick. This is a neat and handy feature on how to give your drums more of a like a live feel. Not dynamically, since you can do that with velocity or volume, we'll get into that soon, but making your drums land out of sync every time to be less computerized and more of like a live performance. It requires 2 audio effects, LFO, a max for live effect, and delay. For this instance, we're going to give the snare drum a livelier feel. First, to set up the delay, drag in the effect and switch sync to time and drag the time value down to 1 millisecond. Next, load in an LFO and inside click map and then click the 1 millisecond time delay in delay. From there, we'll set up the LFO by changing it from signed to random. Drop the depth down and set the maximum value from 100 to 40%. This randomizes the value that the delay is delaying the snare drum, as seen here. Almost forgot to mention, on the delay, change the mode to fade, dry wet to 100% and feedback onto 0%. But in order to get some variations like a live drummer would, we can drag out the master delay value of the channel to give it a negative value. And now our drum element plays around the grid instead of exactly on it. Here's what that looks like in audio. Convolution Reverb. Convolution Reverb makes drums super cohesive. This is a classic noisier trick. Group all your drums together and add in a convolution reverb effect. Next, drop the size and decay down to a low amount. This makes sure the drums are laced in quick and tight reverb. It also pays to use the EQ feature inside the reverb to carve out the low end, as it can add to a little bit of muddiness in your drums. Bypassing the effect, and with it on, you can hear the drums glue together and sound like they're being played inside the same environment. They're just more cohesive. Velocity on your drums is key to get subtle variations and make your drums sound fresh and more dynamic and vibrant. In Ableton 11, they made a super easy way to do this trick, but for now, this is for the Ableton 10, 9, and 8 users out there. If you have your drums in a sampler or drum rack, you can press B on your keyboard to open up the pencil tool, and then you can draw in subtle variations to give your drums character. Or if you want to randomize the velocity, be warned, this will randomize everything in the drum rack. You can go into Ableton's MIDI effects, velocity, and drag in the preset Add Some Random. We'll want to adjust the out high and the out low to reduce the dynamicness for this MIDI effect. Noisy 808. This is a really easy feature to add some extra grit to your 808 kicks. First up, drag in an 808 onto a new channel, and drag the audio effect erosion onto the same channel. Change the mode from sine to white noise and increase the bandwidth and amount to suit your drums and track. Nice and gritty. DMB drum break variations. We all know the classic drum and bass pattern, but if you want to add some variations to keep the listeners guessing or emphasize certain points on the rhythm to shift the groove, most of the time this energy or groove shift is dictated by the kick and snare placement, so get creative with it. Here's some examples of my favorite drum breaks for DMB. How to make old school hip hop drum. First up, we need a drum loop, preferably drum and bass loop. This works pretty well. Next, load up a granulator plugin. Usually the standard grain rate of 5 Hz is perfect for what we're getting up to, but it can go as low as 4 Hz, up to you. Create a blank new audio effect channel and change the input to resampling. With record enabled and recording on, play and hold one note an octave down on your keyboard and sweep the file position across the granulator to capture different hits. The granulator will then create some random splices and repetitions for our new drums. And now with the resampling channel recording that granulator randomization, we can take this audio file and chop and arrange it in a way that resembles an old school hip hop pattern. And lastly, to top it off, once we've got a pattern we're happy with, add the dynamic tube with increased drive and bias for a more vintage sound. Choke groups in drum rack. Say if you want a sample in your drum rack to immediately stop playing as soon as another specific sound is played, choke groups dictate this and you can set them up inside a drum rack. You want to select the chain list and then open up the I/O section. Now you'll be able to see the choke group sections. You have 16 at your disposal, and whichever sounds you put in the same group won't play at the same time. Only one can play. For example, if we put the kick and the snare into the same group, they cut each other off. It's super handy to do this when you're mapping out your drums, especially on tom drum fills as well. You don't want to hear all the toms at the same time. And that's the drum tips. If you happen to like any of the drums in this video, they're all part of our new pack, Cobalt Drums, link in the description.